We continue now at the top of Daf Mem Heyam and Beis and Masechet Sukkah. This is Sukkah Daf 45b. The Gemara here is continuing a statement of Rabbi Avo in the name of Rabbi Lazar. How do you know when a person takes the lulav and takes the hadas? It's as if they brought a carbon, because the pasuk says Isru Chag Bavosim Arkanos Hamizbeach. Again, the same pasuk as Rashi over here says Isru Aguda Shalulav. It refers to the binding of the lulav, and again, that is similar to the Karnos Hamizbeach. That's as if you brought a carbon on the mizbeach. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rabbi Yirmiyah Mishum Rabbi Shimon Ben Yochai, Rabbi Yochanan Mishum Rabbi Shimon HaMechuzi, Mishum Rabbi Yochanan HaMakusi. Rabbi Yirmiyah says in the name of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, and Rabbi Yochanan says in the name of Rabbi Shimon HaMechuzi, in the name of Rabbi Yochanan HaMakusi, Kola Osa Isra Lachag, anyone who makes an Isra to the holiday, Rashi will explain, Ba'achilo Shasiya, by eating and by drinking, Ma'ala Olav HaKosav Ki'ilu Bona Mizbeach, the Pasuk considers it as if the person built a Mizbeach, V'hikrav Olav Karbon, and brought on that Mizbeach a Karbon, Shenemar, like the Pasuk says, Isru Chag Ba'avosim Arkanos HaMizbeach, again, quoting the same pasuk. Rashi over here says, Isru Lachag Aguda Lachag, it means a binding to the holiday, Ba'achilu Shasiya, by eating and drinking, meaning, Shekore Lachag Oneg, means they have pleasure from the holiday, they call the holiday a pleasurable time, but Ma'echolu Mishta, meaning you eat and you drink on the holiday, the point being, if you celebrate the holiday properly with food and drink, it's like bringing a carbon. V'yeshom, some say a different explanation, Yom Shalachar HaChag, Isru Lachag is like we say, Isruchag, the day after the holiday. If you celebrate the day after the holiday with eating and drinking, again, it's like you're bringing a carbon. And the Gemara continues, Amar Chizkiya, Amar Rabbi Yirmiyah, Mishum Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Chizkiya says, in the name of Rabbi Yirmiyah, in the name of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, Kol HaMitzvahs Kulan, by all mitzvahs, Ein Adam Yotzei Bohen Ela Derech Gedei Lasan. You only fulfill the mitzvah if you do it, if you hold the item, or if you place the item in the same manner that it grows. Shenemar, like the Pasuk says, Atzei Shitim Omdim. When it talks about the building of the Mishnah, of the Mishkan, it says that the acacia wood was standing. Tanya Namiachin, the Gemara says we have a brisa that supports this as well. Atzei Shitim Omdim, the same pasuk. What does it mean that the acacia wood was standing? It means exactly what we said. She'omdim derech gedei lasan, that they stood it up in the same direction that it grew. Davar Acher, another explanation. Omdim, what does it mean? Omdim shemamidim es tzipuyan. It holds up the gold plate that surrounded the wood. Davar Acher, another explanation. Omdim, what does it mean? Atzei Shitim Omdim. Shema Tomer, maybe you're going to say avad sivra muvatel sikuyan, that now that the Mishkan has been destroyed, so there's nothing more to do with these boards of wood. They're not going to serve any more holy purpose. Talmud Lomar, the pasuk says, Atzei Shitim Omdim, they're Atzei Shitim acacia wood that is standing. She'omdim liolam liol meolamim. The idea is that it stands forever. The kedusha is always there. And Rashi explains, Kol haMitzvos kagon karshei haMishkan, like a mitzvah, for example, the beams of the Mishkan, viamudim and the pillars of the Mishkan, velulav hadas v'arava, the mitzvah of lulav hadas and arava, also those are held derech gedilos, in the same way that they grow hatachta l'mat. Meaning the bottom of it should be at the bottom and the top on the top. Another explanation is that they hold up the plating. They had gold plate and that was placed there with golden nails. They didn't make a beam. They didn't make like a golden plate that was the same exact size of the beam that stood on its own. Rather, what they did was, again, they fixed it there with these golden nails. Avat sivra mishenigna zol moed batal olamis. Again, maybe you'll say when the Mishkan is gone, so it's totally batal. Sikuyam tochalasam umabatam. Their purpose is over. It's finished. So again, the idea is no. It's omed liolam liol meolamim. Forever, it's going to have this kedusha. And the Gemara continues. V'yomer Chizkiya amar Rabbi Yirmiyah mishum Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. Chizkiya says in the name of Rabbi Yirmiyah, in the name of Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. Yachol ani lifter es kol haolam kulo min adin. I can patter the entire world from judgment. They can be exempt from judgment from the day I was created until now, meaning the suffering. Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai says the suffering that he has been through can patter the entire world from judgment. And if you count my son Eliezer together with me, then it goes from the time the world was created until now, I can patter from judgment. And if you count Yosem ben Uziyo, one of the kings of Israel with us, so then then it's going to be from the time that the world was created until the end of the existence of the world. Rashi over here says, Liftor bizuchusi, in my merit, anisovel kol avonoseim, I'm able to take the burden of all of their sins, upotron min hadin, and I can patter them from judgment. Yosem ben Uziyo tzadika, Yosem ben Uziyo was a king who was a tzadik. V'on of Yosem mishar malachim, he was more humble than the other kings. V'zach b'chibur aviv, he honored his father. V'olav nemar ben yechaberov, it's about him that it says the son who honors his father. Shekol ayam Chayav Mitzorah, all the days that his father was a Mitzorah, V'huayah Shofet Amaretz, he would judge the people. K'nechsev, like the Pasuk says, V'yosam Shofet V'gomer, Lo Natal Olav Keser Malchus B'chayev, he never took the crown during his father's lifetime, V'chol Dinin Shayadon Omer B'shem Aviv, anytime he issued a judgment, he did it in the name of his father. So you see, he also was a tzaddik, the idea again being, Rav Shimon Bar Yochai is saying, in his merit, and also his son's merit, and also the merit of Yosam Ben Uzio, they compadre the whole world from beginning to end, from all judgment. And the Gemara continues, V'yamar Chizki Yomar Rabbi Yirmiyah Mishomar Rav Shimon Bar Yochai, Chizki said in the name of Rabbi Yirmiyah, in the name of Rav Shimon Bar Yochai, Ra'isi b'nei Aliyah v'hein mu'atim, I saw great people, but there are very few of them. Imelefein, if there are 1,000 of them, ani uvni mehen, myself and my son, we are among them. Imeyohem, if there are 100 of them, ani uvni mehen, me and my son, we are among them. Imshnayim hein, if there's only 2 of them, ani uvni hein, it's myself and my son, we are the Bnei Aliyah. So the Gemara says, Umizutri kulihai, are there really so few Bnei Aliyah? Are there so few people who are able to receive the Shechina? V'amar Rava, but Rava said, Tamnei sari alfei dora, havadikami kutshabrichu, said there's a row of 18,000 individuals who are in front of the Shechina, they're in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Shenemar, like it says, saviv shmona asar elef, it says surrounding are 18,000. So you see, it's not just so few people that can be makabel the Shechina, you have 18,000. So the Gemara says, Lokash, it's not difficult. Had mistakli baspaklaria hameira. In one case, we're referring to people who could see HaKadosh Baruch Hu through a clear, bright partition. That's what Rav Shimon Bar Yochai was talking about. Hadalo mistakli baspaklaria hameira. When it says there were 18,000, they're able to see the Shechina, but not through a clear, bright partition. The Gemara says, "With the mistakli baspaklaria hameira mizutri kulihai." But from those who can look through the bright partition, is it really so few people? V'yamar Abaya, but Abaya said, "Lo pachas alma mitzlosin v'shisa tzadikei de mekavli abe shchina b'chol yom." There's never less than 36 tzadikim that can receive the shchina every single day. Shenemar, like the pasuk says, "Ashrei kol chochei lo." Fortunate are all those who wait for him. Lo begematria tzlosin v'shisa have. The word lo lamed vav is in gematria 36. And so the Gemara says, Lokash is not difficult. Ha da aili bebar, ha da aili below bar. Rashi over here says, bebar is bereshus. 36, they can enter bereshus if you have permission. But da aili below bar, but how many can enter in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu without even getting permission? Below reshus, without permission, muatin hein, there are very few. Uvahanu kamar ani uvni mehem. And it was on those that Rav Shimon Bar Yochai said, myself and my son are part of that small, select group that can enter in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu without permission. And the Gemara continues at the two dots. Quoting the Mishnah, B'shas Petiros and Mayan Omer V'chulu, it said that when they departed from the Mizbeach, they would say some kind of praise to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and the Mizbeach. That's what the Mishnah sounded like. So the Gemara asks, V'akamishtatev Shem Shamayim V'davar Acher, isn't this a problem that they're joining together HaKadosh Baruch Hu's name and the Mizbeach as if they're praising them equally? V'tanya, we learned in a Braisa, Kol Mishtatev Shem Shamayim V'davar Acher Nekar Min Olam. Anyone who joins together the name of heaven and something else gets uprooted from the world. Shenemar, like the Pasuk says, Bilti LaHashem Levado, only for Hashem. You can't join Hashem with something else. And so the Gemara says, Hachi Kamar, like, here's really how you understand the Mishnah. Le'anachnu modim to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we thank, v'lochanu m'shabchin, and to you, the Mizbeach, we praise. Le'anachnu modim, again, to him, to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we give our thanks, v'lochanu m'kalsin, and to you, we give our praise. And the Gro over here, in order to avoid the repetition in the Gemara, he changes this modim, which would just be a repeat of exactly what we said, le'anachnu modim, le'anachnu modim. We give thanks to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The Gro changes to the Mavarchim. The second time it means to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we give a blessing. And again, to the Mizbeach, we give a praise. And the Gemara continues at the two dots, quoting the Mishnah, Kamaseu Bechol, the same way they did it on weekdays, they did it on Shabbos. And the Mishnah went on to say that Rabbi Yochanan ben Broka holds that on the seventh day they would bring palm branches to the Mizbeach as well. And so the Gemara says, Amar Rav Huna, Rav Huna says, my time in the Rabbi Yochanan ben Broka, what's the reason of Rabbi Yochanan ben Broka, dechsiv, because the Pasuk says, kapos, it says it like plural when it talks about the palm branches, shnayim, it means two of them, achas lululav, v'achas l'mizbeach, it means one for the lulav, and one for the mizbeach. That's how he learns out this idea that on the seventh day you bring palm branches for the mizbeach. For Rabbanan Amri, the Rabbanan say, no, kapos ksiv, it says it in singular, in other words, you read it as kapos in plural, but it's written as kapas, singular, and therefore there's no allusion to this idea of a second time bringing palm branches. branches. Rabbi Levi says a different reason why they would bring it. Ketamar, it's just like a date. Rashi over here says, Rabbi Levi Omer, Ketamar, time with Rabbi Yochanan broke a lav mikra nafik. It's not learned out from psukim. Elo Savaru, rather it's logical. Simon Yafil the Kilusan Shal Yisrael. It's a sign that's kind of trying to praise Klal Yisrael. Ma Tamar Zed, just like this Tamar tree, Ein lo ela lev echad, only has one heart. Af Yisrael, Ein lohem ela lev echad, laviyem shabashamayim. So to Klal Yisrael, they only have one heart for their Father in heaven. Rashi over here explains, Ein lo ela lev echad, ke ein moach yeshbo kagon beitzo egos vahagefen, ve'ein lo ela beitzo emsoi hazakof viola. It only has this inner part of the wood, the soft part of the wood. It's only got one of them. Viola v'gada l'mala v'lo b'chariyosov mechabdosov. It doesn't spread out in all different directions, referring to these the palm branches, the date tree. So therefore, similarly, when it comes to Klal Yisrael, they only have one heart to their Father in heaven. And the idea over here seems to be that when it comes to the palm tree, it's not like a regular tree where the branches come out from the trunk in all different directions. Rather, the branches come out only at the top. That's the idea, lev echad. It all comes out from one heart, and therefore, so to Klal Yisrael, they only have one heart that's directed towards their Father, Shabbat Shemayim. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rav Yudah Mar Shmuel. Rav Yudah says in the name of Shmuel, Lulav Shiva V'Sukkah Yom Echad. Lulav is 7 days you make a bracha, but Sukkah you only make a bracha one day. My time, what's the reason? Lulav D'Mifsiki Leilos Miyamim. Lulav, where there's an interruption of the nights from the days, meaning you don't take the lulav at night, so you have an interruption. So Kol Yom Mitzvah Be'Apei Nafshayu. Every day becomes an independent mitzvah, and it has its own bracha. But Sukkah D'Lo Mifsiki Leilos Miyamim. Sukkah, where there's a mitzvah at night and during the day, there's no interruption. So Kulu Shiva Kechad Yom Ari. All 7 days of Sukkot are like one long day, and therefore it's just one bracha. And the Gemara continues, V'Rava Barachan, Amar Rabbi Yochanan. Rava Barachan says in the name of Rabbi Yochanan, Sukkah Shiva V'Lulav Yom Echad, the opposite. Sukkah, you make a bracha each of the 7 days, and Lulav, you only make a bracha one day. My time, what's the reason? Sukkah Doraisa, because Sukkah is Doraisa. Shiva, therefore it's a 7 days for the bracha. Lulav Derabbanan, but Lulav, which is only Derabbanan, Sagile Bechadyum. It's enough to make the bracha one day. As Rashi over here says, V'lulav Yom Echad, V'yafa Bishanitel Kol Shiva Zecher L'Migdash. Even though it's taken all 7 days as a remembrance for what was done in the Beis HaMigdash, Ein Mevarchen Bo L'Yom Rishon Shumin HaTorah. The idea over here is you only make a bracha on the first day where it's Doraisa. So again, that's the opinion of Rabbi Yochanan. Sukkah you make a bracha 7 days, lulav only one day. And the Gemara continues, Kiyasa Rav and Amar Rabbi Yochanan, when Ravin came, he said in the name of Rabbi Yochanan, Echad Zev Yechad Zev Shiva, by both of them, whether it's by Sukkah, whether it's by Lulav, you make a bracha all 7 days. Amar Rav Yosef, and Rav Yosef said, Nakad Rav Barachana Biyadach, you should take that which Rav Barachana said, you should go with that opinion. Again, Rav Barachana said that by Sukkah, you make a bracha all 7 days. Tekulo Amoroi, Kaimi Kavase B'Sukkah, because all Amoroim, they follow his lead when it comes to the mitzvah of Sukkah. Rashi over here says, Nakut Rav Barachana Biyadech Damar Sukkah Shiva. He says Sukkah gets 7 days of bracha. Velod Rav Yudah Mar Shmuel Damar Sukkah Yom Echad. Don't follow the opinion that Sukkah is only one day. The Kulo Amoroim Mishmei Rav Yochanan Kaimi Kavase B'Sukkah. All the Amoroim in the name of Rav Yochanan, they said like that by Sukkah. Ushmuel Rav Yochanan Halacha Rav Yochanan. And furthermore, when it's Shmuel against Rav Yochanan, the Halacha follows Rav Yochanan. Kain Matzasi B'Yasoda Shor Rabbeinu Yaakov. That's what I found in the opinion of Rabbeinu Yaakov. And the Gemara continues. Meisvei, we have the following question, and we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Mem Vav Amud Aleph.